So once more I am going to repeat this nuclear fission. First of all, the neutron or bombardment in the nuclear fission chamber means the chamber is containing some uranium 235 molecules, and as the neutrons are released or bombardment means putted, they will this uranium 235 will absorb this neutron and get convert into uranium 236. As this uranium 236 is unstable, it will immediately break down into form the two compound, that is barium and krypton. And due to this, the three neutrons are released, and this fission will have 200 milli equivalent volt of energy. Likewise, the three neutron which is been released will be absorbed by another uranium molecule, and again that uranium will be converted into uranium 236, and again the barium and krypton will be generated, and again 200 milli equivalent volt energy will be generated. Likewise, this is the chain reaction, means again there will be three more neutron, and they will further absorb by another uranium. This type of chain reaction takes place in nuclear chamber. So this is very important. This diagram is also very important, and this explanation is also very important, because question may arise to explain nuclear fission chain reaction. Understood? Because the principle is same as thermal, but the main change is this, how this fuel is generated or converted into thermal energy. Now in this there is one chart that is your work for you to complete this chart. In this chart they have given the table in which they have stated the states in India, which is plants in India. You have to mention their state and capacity milli equivalent volt. I will be providing it later, but first of all you try to complete it. That is, in India the plant, nuclear energy generation plant, are located in Kunandakulam, then Tarapur, then Rawatbhatta, then Kayanga, and these are the places in India. Now you have to find out for example, this Rawatbhatta, the state is Rajasthan, and the capacity megawatt is near about 1400. Understood? Likewise, you have to complete for Kundankulam, Tarapur is in Maharashtra, then Kainga, from your internet, take a help of your net. Then this is the rough diagram or schematic diagram or plant of nuclear energy generation. Now the nuclear power plant does not use fossil fuel like coal, therefore problem like air pollution do not arises, and also if sufficient nuclear fuel is available, this can be a good source of electrical energy. However, there are few problems associated with nuclear power generation plant. That is, first, the product after fission of nuclear fission are also radioactive, means the barium and krypton, which are the smaller molecule, they are still radioactive and release the harmful radiation, and the product is called as nuclear waste. And how to dispose this nuclear waste safely is a big challenge before the scientists, means it is also harming the environment. An accident in nuclear power plant can be very fatal, means life taking. This is because accident may result in release of very harmful radiation. So these are the main problem associated, though it is not polluting the air, but it has a big problem. And another thing is also that related to this, that this nuclear radioactive atom are present in land, means we have to dig for this radioactive compound. So again it is a natural resource, we are not getting it in a chemical lab. So we have to wait till this nuclear radioactive compounds are generated again in the lab. Now you can focus on this diagram also, which is related to the nuclear power plant. Sometime this diagram is there and questions are asked related to this nuclear power plant. So you can understand this. There is cooling tower, then generator, then turbine. This cooling tower, you are showing the U band, means for release of hot water and then retaining the water again into the cooling chamber or tower. Here is the condenser which releases the temperature of steam is lower down, and running the turbine. And initially there is a nuclear reactor. And this is the boiler, nuclear reactor. This is the boiler. In boiler, it is heating up the water, and then steam is forced on turbine. Then steam is condensed and again entered into the cooling tower. So this is the very important. And in this nuclear fission chain reaction is very important.